Welcome back to another episode of this Danktastic adventure, and today we will be playing as Algeria. Let's get started. God damn it, not American Samoa. Alright, so first things first, we're going to build some electronics factories. That's usually our go-to at the beginning. Great to export, they produce quite a bit of cash. Invest in research. And invest in research spending and government spending. Tunisia will be our first go-to, so that way we can get phosphate. That's going to help us out quite a bit. Once we take them, we're pretty much going to have a monopoly on that, with the exception of Kazakhstan, I think. Maybe one or two other nations, but Tunisia has the bulk of it. Those are about ready to pop. Alright, let's start this war up. We will not be allying with the Frenchies today. I think step one's gonna be unite North Africa. That's gonna help us out quite a bit. If we can go into Spain as well, that's also gonna be useful. They have some tungsten up in the north. Import more gold and copper. Looks like we have an Egypt player. That's alright though. Italy's AI, we could go through there. That'd help secure the Mediterranean. There's a Gibraltar player too. That's usually, that's kind of rare. Invest more points into research. What the heck is happening here? Alrighty then. Well, in any case, we're going to be going down the socialist path. I don't know what the hell is going on here. But, as usual, we'll go down socialism, then communism for the production buff and war exhaustion buff. Helps out with manpower too, but that's not usually why I go down that route. Import titanium and tungsten. We'll buy as much of this as we can. Cancel our trades. Shoot. Sometimes that happens when you export or import heavily. An easy fix, though. Perfect. Hell do they want? Nope. Alright, we're fortunate they don't have aircraft. But they are exporting electronics, I think. Go down to a mass attack for that extra manpower. Keep having shortages. That's alright, that'll resolve itself soon. Alright, Spain is allied to France, so we're gonna wanna get a few frigates ready just in case they send troops down. Though it shouldn't be too big of a deal. What the hell is going on here? Hopefully that isn't directed towards me. We're not going to peace out with them. We're just going to push through Spain and annex them after. Oh, that's India. What the hell is India doing here? That's a little worrying. Can almost get ground support. That's going to help quite a bit. Let's rush straight for Madrid. Get rid of these factories. Come on, Frigate, get over here. Perfect. Awesome. Now we have ground support. I think they're AI now. In that case, we will go after France. Looks like our wizard brethren is playing as Bulgaria. We shall accept their alliance. Alright, that's lucky. We can get rid of these guys now. Take out Madrid just in case someone else joins. That should drastically reduce their manpower gain and cap, so that'll be quite useful. Then we can focus on France. I'll just let these guys do whatever they're doing. Take out Andorra through the airport. Should probably send some troops over to Turkey to help out our wizard. Otherwise, he's gonna get annexed. they scorched. In that case, we'll just finish up Spain, then we can take them out after. Ah, shoot. That's a wee bit of a problem. I just lost all our trades because I was being wasn't paying attention. After the Levant. I was not paying attention there either. Oops. Take out Portugal while we're at it, too. Now France is gonna be gone. The US is just sending tanks through the flames. Kind of a ballsy move. Now, if they're willing to sacrifice their tanks, then go for it. Probably be a lot closer to Quantum had I paid attention. But I didn't. Oh well, I do that quite a bit. It's easy to get fixated on something else in this. Egypt is allied to India. Interesting. should be able to hit Egypt from two fronts. Pretty soon, at least. We'll take out Libya, take out the rest of the Middle East, or at least the bulk of it. Then we can push into Egypt, secure the Suez. I don't think India will be able to intervene. At least ideally they won't, if we're quick. Go down to communism. I have no idea what is going on with this menu. I have never seen that. Maybe we can get a few cities from France. Worth a shot, I guess. Figured the US would have taken more. Throw people into gulags. India is in the British Isles. I don't think I've seen that before. That is a bit odd. Grab some of Italy before Germany ends up taking it all. Send these guys to Rome, then we'll just put them auto cap. Oh, there's Yugoslavia. Well, looks like they have died to the hands of the Dank Wizzard. These guys are going to need reinforcements. We'll go with the Military Service Act. Seeing as our military upkeep was at 6 mil. Oh dear, what's this war gonna It's not gonna... Alright, I guess I'm not joining the war. Alright. Fair enough. Improve infrastructure. Alright, these guys are dying of attrition. That's not doing me any good. There we go. Paris is finally down. Took long enough. Alright, looks like Japan's unleashing its wrath upon China. Along with the, oh wait, nope. Thought that was Russia, it's not. Similar shade of, color though, for its, political borders. Oh, the US is AI now. I'm thinking India and Japan are going to be the biggest threats. More so Japan. They're unleashing Hirohito's wrath over here. India, I don't know what the fuck they're doing. Ah, they took Sierra Leone. Perfect. Okay, finish up Kuwait. go after Liechtenstein again after. They have a little bit of tungsten. Alright, I think we're producing enough manpower that we can go to balance. Alright, I'm not too worried about India. As long as we can finish this war quick, it shouldn't be a problem. Shoot, dying of attrition again. Alright, I'm thinking Egypt is going to be first, once we finish up here, and then we can deal with Germany. Let's get some submarines in the English Channel. Alright, let's start this up, I guess. Get these guys over to Cyprus first. You can get some destroyers, just bombard them. Let's see, what do they have for troops? Oh, that's not bad. Yeah, we can do this. Oh, India is not even a player anymore. Okay. So much for that. Yeah, I'm not too worried about this war. This should be fine. Alright, we're losing quite a bit of money there. Bulk of it in research spending, more than anything else. Might have to cut that back a little bit in a moment. Either that, or just convert our entire military to infantry. Get rid of all our tanks. Yeah, we're spending 3 mil in tanks. That's quite a bit. send these guys over to invade Saudi Arabia. I think all that's left is to go after Japan, really. I think they're the only superpower left. Once we finish up in Europe, in the Middle East, that is. I mean, I can go through Iran and into Pakistan, but I don't really see too much of a point. Liechtenstein down. Oh yeah, I forgot. I was going to invade Mauritania. What happens, I'm all over the map, and then I forget that I'm gonna do something. Or I forget to invest points into something. That's a reoccurring theme with me in my playthroughs. There we go. Saudi will fall pretty quick. These guys might take a while though, because I only sent these two tanks. I'll send a few more. Units always die of attrition in this region, too. That makes it a pain to take out sometimes. Especially if a player owns it. put artillery here or forts. Good luck. Unless you have an aircraft carrier. Or you're willing to sacrifice some units. Roads are definitely a must in this region. Though I'm not going to bother building them. Ah, screw it. We'll give him Istanbul, too. I think we'll take out Japan, then we'll wrap this game up. We'll make them Arabic. Tokyo-stan. Japanistan. Beijingistan. Seems they have a mixture of tanks and infantry. Shouldn't be too hard to deal with. Oh boy. Cash seems to be okay still, thankfully. Seven battleships, six destroyers, 18 submarines, and one aircraft carrier. Yeah, I think that'll suffice. Looks like Japan has intentions of invading this little feller. We can't allow that. Time to be a good Samaritan. And turn Japan Arabic. Oh, God damn it. These guys don't even want to move. You have to be careful when going through areas like this. Even if they pass, or you set a path through the middle, sometimes they get caught on some invisible ledge, I guess you could call it, and they disembark. Then they die of attrition. I've lost many armies due to that. Back in the day, Denmark was pretty common for that. Before the canal, you'd have to go through here. And they'd always get caught in this little region. Grade A, pain in the ass. probably going to want to invest heavily into naval guns. That and naval missiles. This is another region you have to be careful with. This entire area is just a death trap, for that matter. Alright, they're building some frigates and destroyers. Anything else? Doesn't look like he's building a massive navy. I could be wrong though. Could have a ton queued up there. Not really worried about the destroyers. Battleships might be a little bit of a problem, but I have 18 submarines as well. Oh, look at that. They passed through pretty safely for once. This region has just destroyed entire naval, operations and invasions before. Oh, what the hell is this? He's warning Japan. I come here to help you, and, Alright, well, I guess, they're next. It's all or nothing. Let's do this. Three battleships, two destroyers. Yeah, that's not gonna get them very far. I say that, watch my navy get absolutely crushed. Looks like his battleship is trapped in there. Have fun getting that out, buddy. put our troops over here. I think the bulk of their troops, if they're gonna mass spawn them, are gonna amalgamate here in the major cities. I don't know how much manpower he has, so best to be a bit careful. Alright, now we'll go over to there. Let these guys recuperate, and then we'll send them off on a warpath. Perfect. Alright, we've pretty much eliminated every other superpower. Well, we have. Oh, nice. They've expanded quite a bit. We must be going for Mayan Empire. Thank you. Nope, they're AI now. Fair enough. I think this is a job well done. Japan will fall apart pretty soon, and that pretty much leaves the world with no other threat. Doesn't look like there's any other formables we can do, so I think this concludes the Danktastic Adventures of Ryan. Thank you for watching.